Hi everyone, I'm here in Guelph and behind me is Drive Test Examination Center. And we are here to do G-Fuel road test. We're gonna do a mock-up exam and go on an actual route and give you all the tips and tricks you need to pass your road test from the first time. Now this is the front of the building. This is where you come in and register, but your car has to be parked behind this building. And you park your car in these numbered spots over here. I recommend parking the car like this, so backwards. So when you start your road test, you simply go forward and you're on your way. All right, so here we are in the car, getting ready for examiner to show up. We went inside, we've registered. When you come in to register, if there is a lineup, you don't have to wait in the lineup. You just go straight and you say that you have a road test booked. And today I'm here with an expert in this field who's gonna help us, guide us through this mock-up test.
Hi everyone. So before the road test, when you're waiting in the car and you already registered and you staying here, and when examiners will come, they gonna verify your ID. They ask your name, what's your name, what's your address, make sure you know your postal code and what's your date of birth. Then they ask you to start the car and they go in around the car to make a circle check, to check your lights and signals. It's gonna be like signal left, signal right, brake lights or stop lights, honk the horn, make sure you have no cracks on the windshield. And it's a good idea to go to the gas station before the road test to fill up the tank.
Tires should be in good condition.
And then examiner sit down in the car and ask you to sign. Before it was papers, right now they have iPads. So you sign iPad and you start your road test. Okay, so start your car, let's go.
And a question on the car, if something is wrong with your car, can you ask someone else to give you a car?
You can use a rental car, you can use like your friends and family cars for the road test. So if you have G2 road test, so somebody should accompany you. Because if you fail, examiner will ask who gonna drive you home. So it's gonna be if you use a friend's car, so a friend should be here and examiner should see this friend. Or your mom or dad, like your family, brother, sister.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, should be another person too. So start your car, let's go through the route.
And another question on the jacket. If it's winter,
it's a good idea to take off your jacket.
You want to be comfortable.
Yeah, you should feel comfortable. Nothing should be like, bulky. And if it's winter jacket, it's too bulky. And your movements should be like nice. And you feel yourself much like, much more freedom and much more comfortable. Yeah.
Okay. And today it's raining. So you want to make sure you know where your windshield wipers are, you know where your ventilation is.
Ventilation.
Because it's going to get foggy, maybe your
defroster of the back window.
If it's winter, defroster. Defrost your windows, make sure everything is clear, you don't have snow on your car, snow on the roof.
Yeah. And if you're waiting for examiner and your like windows getting foggy, it's a good idea to start your car like in advance and defog your window. Maybe you open your side windows a little bit that should be like ventilation, and then your windows should be nice and clean.
Mm-hmm.
And make sure you know how your windshield works. And
if it's raining really, like if it's raining, do they cancel exam?
No, it's gonna be.
Even if it's thundering?
If it's a thunderstorm, if it's rain, yeah. The only the like winter conditions when it's like icy road, that's the only way they cancel the road test. Sometimes it's too much snow, but yeah, so snow and ice on the road, rain doesn't matter, it's gonna be the road test in the rain too.
Okay,
so buckle up, don't forget to buckle up.
If you forget, that's bad.
That's bad, yeah. Okay, and
can you fail right away or?
No, usually examiners
understand that
they understand that you are excited and
nervous
and nervous little bit. Sometimes they ask you, "Are you nervous?" But don't say you're nervous. Say, "Okay, I'm excited." But like everything is under control.
Don't say you're scared.
Yeah, you're not scared, you're not nervous. Yeah, you feel comfortable and the confidence, and it's like it should be like this. Okay, if you're ready, let's go to the right.
Okay, and make sure you use the arm brake.
Yeah.
All throughout your test, you show signals, you move your head, check your blind spot,
rear view, you check in your rear view every 5 to 10 seconds. It's impossible to check it like every 5 to 10 seconds, but it's you're gonna check it like from time to time.
Mm-hmm.
Really, like pretty often.
And if it's sunny day, sunglasses, would you recommend?
No, or? I don't recommend. My personal advice is like don't use the sunglasses for the road test unless you have prescription. Because examiners, they want to see your eyes, how you're checking your sides, left, right, left, rear view. So they want to see your eyes, how your eyes are working during the road test. And so you may ask examiner, like, would you mind my sunglasses? They say yes, but I don't recommend to use sunglasses for the road test. Even if it's bright day, especially in winter time when it's like lots of snow and white. But don't use it, like, you're gonna survive for these 10-12 minutes of the road test.
And exaggerate the movements, so you...
Yeah, chin up when you're checking your rear view.
It's hard, but if you can do that, that helps the examiner to see that, okay, you actually, you checked, you went left, right, when you passed the intersection.
Yeah.
Okay.
And if you're ready, let's go to the right.
Okay, hand brake, put on D, show signal right, check for
cars and pedestrians.
Cars and pedestrians, no one on the left.
Yeah, here's a place of excitement. Sometimes people too excited here, sometimes they're just running across the road under the wheels of your car. And they pass the road test, and they don't even see that like your car is moving toward them. And it's like just slow down, let them go first. Okay, so we're exiting from this plaza, and we're turning left to the Silver Creek. It's no stop sign here. But you're turning to the road, so wait, both ways should be no cars.
All clear.
Turning left. And then switch your lane to the right, and we're turning right on the traffic light to Woodlawn Road West. So Woodlawn is a major street here, speed limit is 60.
Check for
mirror signal, blind spot is no pedestrians. Okay, speed limit is 60. We're going straight. Okay. Stop before stop line on traffic light. So that's here in Guelph. That's why people like this examination center. that it's not too much traffic on the road in comparison with Toronto. And if you have highway test, and it's a highway speed limit on the highway is 70 kilometers per hour, it's gonna be highway 6. And we have no here highways 400 series. Okay, after this, traffic light examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left if it's safe. Make sure if it's safe, check your mirrors, signal, make a signal in blind spot, and we have a center lane for the left turn. So examiner will ask you to make a left turn to Royal Road. If you miss Royal Road, it's going to be next one Imperial Road. It's practically two identical streets. So for left turn, we have a center lane here, and we turn in left to the Royal Road. So if you have no speed limit signs on the streets, it's speed limit is 50 by default in all Guelph area. So right here we have no speed limit signs so far. So we suppose it's 50, speed up till 50. It's just industrial area, so we have two railway road tracks here. When you're crossing railway road tracks, just check left, right, left. Don't slow down off your foot from the pedals of gas or brakes. It should be three wheels when you're crossing them. And it's just like
you're
crossing rollover with three wheels. That's it. Two railroad tracks, and all trains usually go in during the night time. I never saw the train here during the daytime, but just in case if you have train, you have to stop 5 meters before the tracks and wait for them. Okay, that's another one. You check left, right, left, no train. It's a good idea if you check left, right, left and say to examiner, no train,
no train,
and cross. Okay, and this traffic light, we turn in left. It's Speedway Avenue West, we turn in left. So your test here, G2 exit test or G-full test, how people like to call it. It consists two parts, city and the highway. You're gonna be on the highway 6 with speed limit 70 two times. So you're entering, changing lanes and exiting.
Is highway first?
Yeah, it's
a second?
Highway first, and then it's gonna be city. In the city, you have to make a 3-point turn parallel parking in the roadside stop or emergency stop when you use a 4-way signal button. And on the highways, you're gonna be two times. So you're entering, exiting. And then again, you're entering, changing lanes, and exiting.
Keep control of your wheel, have two hands ideally on the wheel.
Yeah.
You can of course scratch your nose, but
but usually just keep both hands on the steering wheel during the road test all the time. So your steering wheel should be under control all the time.
Don't do palm steering.
Don't
like
do
with
palm
one
steering.
Hand,
yeah. Hand over
hands,
hand.
Hand over hand. So
yeah, it's a good idea.
I know.
Yeah.
Same thing to the right. Yeah.
And check your rear view every 5 to 10 seconds. It's impossible to check it 5 to 10 seconds, but from time to time you have to check it and chin up, exaggerate a little bit. Examiner
turn on the left lane and automatically switch to the right without any direction.
Yeah, examiner will not gonna ask you to change your lane after the left turn to the right. You have to do it by yourself. And
right one is for driving, left for passing. So that's why you stay in this lane.
Left lane for passing, slow moving vehicles.
Or turning left.
Or turning left. Okay, and first traffic light after this turn is gonna be highway 7. And we're gonna turn in right and enter in the highway.
Special lane for
Han Long Parkway or Highway 6. Okay, and you have to accelerate till 70. You see this 70. Limit sign, and then you merge at 70. So
okay,
accelerate, make a signal in advance. Okay, good. lane left, please, if it's safe.
Okay, signal, mirror signal, blind spot, MSB, like a formula. Okay.
And change your lane to the right. And we're gonna be exit to Willow, to the right.
To the right?
Willow Road to the right, we're exiting. Don't slow down on the main lane on the highway. You switch your lane to the exit lane and then you're slowing down for like at here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay, yield
sign, open. No traffic.
Okay. Signals.
Okay, and let's make a right turn right here. First intersection, mark some road, you turn in right. It's just a calm residential area, not too much traffic in here, you just keep going straight. If you have no speed limit signs, you remember it's 50 by default, so you can go 50. If you have some intersections, you checking, just look at these intersections, checking left, right, left, watch for pedestrians, speed limit should be under control. Okay. And we're going back to Speedwell Avenue. And we're gonna be enter highway again, second time.
So here we're driving through residential area.
Yeah, this is residential area. And the end of this street, it's a T intersection. At this stop sign, we turn in right again, Speedway Avenue West. Stop sign only for us, make sure it's no cars.
Stop before stop sign.
Yeah.
There's no line.
No, it should be, both lanes from the left should be free. Not only your lane, which one you turn in, but second one too. Should be no traffic from the left.
Turn in the right lane.
In the right lane, staying in the right lane, and we're gonna be enter highway again. Hanlon Parkway or Highway 6.
And we're going right?
Yeah, we're going to the right, towards south. Okay. And we have special inlet.
Show signal.
Again, you have to accelerate till 70 and then you merge. Make a left signal in advance. Acceleration should be pretty energetic.
Okay,
checking your mirror signal and blind spot before merging. That's good. Then examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left if it's safe. You estimate if it's safe to do so. Yeah, speed limit and check your speed after changing your lane. And first traffic light, we turn in left. It's Willow Road, but right now we turn in left. We have special inlet for left turn and a special traffic light for left turn only. So you have to wait until this left turn signal gonna be green.
Mm-hmm. You can't even advance.
even if it's like okay,
arrow.
Right now it's green arrow, we're good. Make sure you have no pedestrians.
Okay.
And after left turn, you switch your lane to the right automatically.
Okay.
And we turn in right to Silver Creek Parkway North. So this traffic light, we turn in right. You remember you can make a right turn on red after full stop before stop line. And make sure it's no cars from the left. Both lanes should be free, so should be no cars.
Okay, no cars. No pedestrians.
Okay. speed limit is 50 and examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left.
True signal.
If it's safe to do so. Yeah. And first intersection, we're gonna make a left turn for three-point turn, parallel parking and roadside stop.
So just here?
So just here. Ajax Street. Okay, let's go straight. And here is another intersection. We're gonna make a left turn again. Sliman Avenue.
So here is no stop sign. It
no
looks
stop.
Like yield.
Yield. If no cars, you just turn without stopping. Mm-hmm. If you have some cars, wait for them. Okay, let's make a roadside stop or emergency stop.
Okay. Not gonna block any road exits here.
Yeah.
Park right here.
Leave driveways free.
Put on P, handbrake. Turn the four-way signal on and well, it's uphill it looks like, so I'll just turn my wheels to the left.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. So uphill with the curb, you turn your wheels left,
mm-hmm.
out of the curb, and
everything else is to the right.
Yeah, everything else to the right. Don't block driveways, park beside the grass, that's it.
Avoid fire hydrants.
Fire hydrants 3 meters before, 3 meters after. And no parking. Okay, let's get out from here.
Okay, remove handbrake, put on D, remove the signal light.
Yeah, one of the most common mistakes, like when you forget to off your four-way signal. You just make a signal left, it's clicking, but it's like clicking on four ways.
Yeah.
So don't forget to off your emergency signal button.
Okay, signal left, and we're getting out of here.
Yeah. Okay, let's make a three-point turn.
Show a signal. Left, signal right. Check for cars front and back. Signal left.
Yeah, should be no cars in front, no cars behind. If you have some cars, just wait.
Go rear, signal right. Wheels all the way to the right, look back. Not touching any curbs.
Yeah, don't touch the curb.
Left. And
okay, that's good. Let's make a parallel parking with this car.
Okay, the truck?
Yeah, pickup truck.
Okay.
Make sure you practice parallel parking a lot with different cars. Pickup trucks, SUVs, minivans, regular cars, sedans. Because you don't know what kind of car is gonna be on your road test. We have a special video here how to learn how to make a perfect parallel parking. You can learn to do this perfectly in 20 minutes, half an hour, but make sure you practice a lot with different cars. You have to feel pretty confident with this exercise. Don't touch the curb, main idea.
Okay, make it a little straight, maybe go forward a little bit, but
yep.
Again, park the car. Handbrake. Here it's downhill now, so wheels to the right.
Yep, towards the car.
Foot off the brake and gas and
yeah. Wait. So sometimes examiner will gonna open the door and check the distance between your car and the curb. Ideal distance is 1 foot, 30 centimeters. But don't be freaked out, like they just having fun.
Okay,
that's it. Let's get out from here.
Put on, remove the handbrake, make the wheel straight, and show signal left. We're gonna back out a little bit here. Okay, go put on D, turn left.
No cars in front, no cars no behind. Cars. If you have some cars, wait.
Okay,
that's all three exercises in the city area. So we turn in. Right to back to Ajax Street.
And okay, there's no stop signs or anything, so we just go.
We're going straight and first stop sign speed, Silver Creek, we're turning right. So all three exercises, parallel parking, 3-point turn and emergency stop, that's all your tasks in the city part. Okay,
stop sign.
Stop sign only for us, we stop before sidewalk or if you have stop line before stop line. Okay,
no
turn
cars
right.
In both lanes, turn into right lane.
Okay, going straight. No speed limit signs, we suppose it's 50 by default and we're going straight till first traffic light is gonna be Willow Road, we're turning right.
Okay.
Okay.
Showing signal right.
Show signal in advance, your signal should click. Clicks like 5 to 8 times. 3 clicks is not enough before you actually making turn.
Full stop, wait
full
for
stop,
pedestrians.
Wait for pedestrians. Pedestrians should step on the curb.
Okay, crossed on the curb, green light, but it's they're also crossing here.
Yeah, from this side, pedestrians should pass your way on the other way of the road. You can make a turn.
So right here is
good? Yeah, is good. He's already on the other side of the road. Okay, and here we have a sign that like two lanes merging in 70 meters is a good idea to make a signal mirror and check your blind spot and switch your lane to the left. And we're going straight. So here in Willow Road we have very interesting sign. It's a school zone and the speed limit sign is 40 when it's flashing. Right now it's not flashing, so it's we keep going 50. Mm-hmm. But if it's flashing, when it's weekdays and a school time, especially in the morning or afternoon, sometimes it's
40.
Flashing, you have to go 40. And here's the downhill, your car accelerate very easily, so keep your speed under control all the time. And sometimes you have some cars in front of you, you just keep in distance, but cars in front of you going too fast. Okay, so keep your speed under control. Dawson, we turning left. This traffic light, Dawson Road. We have special lane for the left turn. No oncoming traffic or cars far enough. And we turning left to Dawson. Again, we have a special lane for bicyclists here. Leave this lane free. Speed limit is 50.
Maintain.
And we're going straight. We're gonna go through this industrial area by Dawson Road. And again, we have a couple rail road trucks. So when you're crossing them, check left, right, left, and off your foot from gas and brakes, just should be free wheels. Don't slow down, just keep going 50. When you're crossing intersection, you're checking left, right, left. From time to time, you're checking your rear view, chin up, exaggerate a little bit. Examiners should see that like you're checking rear view for sure.
Slow down, and when you're slowing down, you can check the rear view. Good idea.
Yeah, if you have any approaching vehicles from behind, and if you stop, it's a good idea. Any car in front of you, it's a good idea. You have to see the rear wheels of that car. And if examiner is short guy, take this into consideration. Like, he wants.
You want to be able to get out.
To see. Yeah. Okay.
The railroad road here.
Another one.
So not slowing down.
Yeah.
Just looking left, right.
Yeah. I never saw the trains here during the daytime. Usually all trains go in by night, at night.
Mm-hmm.
So, but just in case, if you have a train and the train is usually making a sound signal and you stop 5 meters before the truck and wait for the country and to pass. Mm-hmm. Another one is if you have firefighters, police, or ambulance with sirens and signals, you have to pull over to the right and wait for them. It doesn't matter if they're going like oncoming way or from behind of you. So you have to pull over to the right, wait for them, and not following them less than 150 meters from behind.
Should we turn left here?
We turn in left to Woodlawn Road West, and we're going back to examination center. Another question is regarding if you sometimes we have school buses, especially the school zone, is like when school finish at 3 o'clock or after 3 o'clock. So if you have school bus with emergency signals waiting to pick up the kids or drop off the kids, so it's a the rule is you have to stop 20 meters before the school bus. It doesn't matter school bus on your side of the road or other side of the road, opposite side of the road. Just all cars stop, all traffic stops, and wait for the school bus off their emergency signals.
Turn left in the left lane.
In the left lane.
Automatically switching.
To the right, speed limit is 60, speed up.
Speed up
and
60.
After this turn, first traffic light, arrow road, you're turning right back to examination center parking place.
Maintaining 60.
Yeah.
Mirror, checking mirror,
yeah,
signal.
Switching to the right, we're gonna make a right turn on arrow. Again, if it's a red, full stop on red before stop line. If no cars, no pedestrians, we can make a right turn. It's safe to do so. And second, turn left and left to the parking lot behind the building. You start from this parking lot, you finish at this parking lot again. And the last task examiner will ask you to make a back parking or front in parking. If it's back parking, it's usually to the right side. Make sure you practice back parking a lot. We have a video, a special video, how to learn a back parking, and probably you can learn it to make it perfectly, like in 20 minutes. But you have to practice left and right. Okay, let's make a reverse parking in a spot number 20.
Okay, find it. Okay, where it is. Okay, I see it.
It's a good idea if you can make it from the one shot, but if it's not, then you can go back and forth to fix your position.
Okay.
Main idea, you have to be in your parking spot in between two lanes, and it should be enough distance for you and for your examiner to get out from the car.
Mm-hmm. Straight, looks like it's gonna be one shot, and but if you don't make it, adjust.
You can adjust back and
as
forth.
Long as it's not like you're not adjusting 5-10 times, right?
One time is good. Yeah,
a handbrake
off your engine,
turn off the car,
and examiner gonna say you're okay, you pass the road test, congratulations. And go to the counter, get your temporary G-Full license, and
yay,
you're gonna get your new plastic card
in the mail.
Through the mail in 2, maybe 3 weeks right now.
Mm-hmm.
So that's it.
Okay. So not super hard. Now we answered I think a lot of the common questions that we get asked on the channel. What I would ask is, what are some of the common ways you can potentially fail a G-Full exam?
One of most common mistakes, you don't make a full stop at the stop sign. Make sure it's no rolling. It's like you make a full complete stop. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, and then you go. That's one mistake. Another one, before the road test, examiner will ask you how many times you've been on the highways, like highways 400 series. Okay, the right answer is like 100 times. Say at least 50 times, because you have to have enough
practice experience
to go through the highway. It's not your first time you go into the highway with the examiner, because they're gonna freak out, like. So right answer, we recommend to answer, okay, 100 times I've been on the highways, like 400 series, more than 100 times I've been on the highways, 80 kilometers per hour. So that's the right answer.
Mm-hmm.
So main failure is like, once again, it's like didn't make a full stop on a stop sign.
Mm-hmm.
And you accelerate speed limit 40, especially the school zone, and you go in plus 10 from this posted speed. That's failed. And another one, when you made making 3-point turn of parallel parking, you touch the curb.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll make probably a separate video on this topic. What are some of the, you know, top ways that you can potentially pass, fail your test so you don't make those mistakes. But you can also fail if you have a combination of little mistakes.
Yeah.
Right? So if you maybe forget in the beginning to buckle up, you do too many corrections when you're reversing, when you are...
if you're not checking your blind spot, you miss your blind spot 8 times, that's it, the end of the road test. And combination of mistakes, if you made small mistakes, and you made small mistakes like 30 times, that's it. They just count mistakes. More than 30 mistakes, you're not gonna pass. So,
even if they're really tiny.
But the main idea of test is safe driving.
Mm-hmm.
If you're safe, you
polite on the road.
Polite on the road, your lane changes is smooth and nice and polite, and your speed limit under control, you're good.
One person actually failed the test by observing the rules, but not preventing an accident when they could have prevented, or the accident didn't happen, but the examiner had to slam on the brakes when the car was backing out from the driveway, and they were driving, but they never slowed down because it was their way. So
right of way, yeah.
So that's another recommendation. Just if you're correct.
Yeah.
But you can prevent an accident, do so, right? If somebody doesn't stop at the stop sign, and even though it's your turn, don't create an accident.
Yeah, yeah.
So
let the stupid go first. So even if you have right of way, but the other person's like going like
they're speeding,
speeding, they didn't stop for the stop sign. Okay, just like let them go first.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I think we'll end it here. So this was Guelph G-Fuel road test, or G2 exit
road test,
as it's properly named. And if we didn't answer your question, please write it in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, please like the video. It will help other people find it, and share it with your friends if you have friends or family doing the test here. If your test is not here and it's somewhere else or it got rescheduled, we have other videos in all the other Ontario examination centers, so you can see the full route for those tests as well. And you can come in, practice before your exam, go on the route a few times. It will give you the confidence you need to pass it. Anything else?
So if you like this video,
subscribe,
ring the bell, and good luck for your road test and safe driving for all.
Yep. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye.